Hello dosto, namaskar, I am JK. In the series of cement chemistry, we already learned the hydration of cement. Now I would like to request Dr. K. Mohan sir to tell us about the type of cement. Cement ke kitne type hote hain? What is the application of each and every cement? Sir, iske baare mein thoda sa hum logon ko brief mein samjhaiye.
Mr. Singh, you have asked me to discuss a very important topic of types of cement. Now I will talk about types of cement. There are about 21 types of cement, some of which are not covered under BIS, that is Bureau of Indian Standard Specifications. First, I will list the type of cement and then I will discuss in brief each type of cement. Number one is ordinary Portland cement, OPC, and IS specification is IS 269/2015. Next is Portland Pozzolana cement, that is PPC, IS 1489/2015. Next is Portland slag cement, PSC, IS code is IS 455/2015. Number four is composite cement, CC, that is IS 16415/2015. Rapid hardening Portland cement, RHPC, IS 8041/1989. Next is extra rapid hardening cement. Seventh is quick setting cement. Eighth, low heat Portland cement, that is LHPC, IS 12600/1989. Then we have sulfate resisting Portland cement, that is SRPC, IS 12330/1988. Number 10 is super sulfated cement, SSC, IS 6909/1990. Next is hydrophobic Portland cement, HPC, that is IS 8043/1991. Next is white Portland cement, WPC, IS 8042/1989. 13 is masonry cement, MC, IS 3466/1988. Next is Royal Welsh cement, OWC, IS 8229/1986. Number 15 is high alumina cement, HSE, IS 6452/1989. Then we have colored cement. Next, air entraining cement. 18 is expansion cement. 19 is ready set cement. Number 20 is concrete sleeper grade cement, IRS T40/1985. Now, recent revision has also come. Number one is very high strength cement. So now, each of the type of cement will be discussed in brief. So, let us first discuss ordinary Portland cement, OPC. OPC is classified into three grades, namely 33 grade, 43 grade, and 53 grade OPC, depending upon the strength of cement at 28 days. Ordinary Portland cement 33 grade, that is OPC 33, is produced by grinding clinker with 4 to 5% gypsum. According to BIS, the minimum compressive strength of 33 grade OPC shall be 33 MPa at 28. Presently, OPC 33 grade is not being made in India. Applications are used for general low-rise civil construction work under normal environmental conditions. Next, we have ordinary Portland cement 43 grade, that is OPC 43. OPC 43 grade cement is a moderate strength Portland cement. It is made by grinding clinker of C3S content about 50% with 4 to 5% gypsum. Performance improver like limestone, fly ash, granulated blast furnace slag up to 15% can be used along with clinker and gypsum. According to BIS, the minimum compressive strength of 43 grade OPC shall be 43 MPa at 28 days. Applications used for general civil engineering construction works, including residential, commercial, and industrial buildings like roads, bridges, flyovers under normal environmental conditions. Then precast items such as blocks, tiles, and pipes. Then for non-structural works such as plastering and flooring. And the last one is ordinary Portland cement 53 grade, that is OPC 53. OPC 53 grade cement is a high strength Portland cement. It is made by grinding clinker of C3S contain about 53 to 55% with 4 to 5% gypsum. Performance improvers like limestone, fly ash, granulated blast furnace slag up to 5% can be used along with clinker and gypsum. According to BIS, the minimum compressive strength of 53 grade OPC shall be 53 MPa at 28 days. Applications of OPC 53 grade are used for high rise buildings, bridges, flyovers, chimneys, where high grade cement is normally required. Then used for precast concrete items such as paving blocks, tiles, and building blocks. Then used also for pre-stressed concrete components and runways, concrete roads, and bridges. Next is Portland Pojana cement, that is PPC. It is manufactured by grinding clinker, gypsum, and fly ash 15 to 35%. I'll just like to tell you that fly ash is a byproduct from the thermal power plant. And PPC has got low heat of hydrogen. It has got higher resistance to chemical attack, that is attacks of sulfates and chlorides, imparts long-term strength and durability. It has higher water tightness and low permeability. Ultimate strength of PPC is more than OPC. And PPC reduces alkali aggregate reaction, and it shows low shrinkage on time. So these are the benefits of PPC. Then applications. It is used for general construction works and especially suitable for works in aggressive environmental conditions. Then it can also be used in for water retaining structures, marine works, mass concreting such as dams, retaining walls, and sewage. Next one is Portland slag cement, that is PSC. It is manufactured by grinding clinker, gypsum, and granulated blast furnace slag to the tune of 25 to 70%. Blast furnace slag is also a byproduct from the steel industry. PSC has also additional advantages like it has low heat of hydrogen. It provides increased resistance to attack of sulfate and chloride. It imparts long-term strength and durability. It has higher water tightness and low permeability. And PSC reduces alkali aggregate reaction. Now let us see the applications of PSC. It is used for general construction work, but mainly preferred for construction of marine structures. And in coastal areas, where excessive amounts of chloride and sulfate are present. It can also be used for mass concrete. Next one is composite cement, CC. It is manufactured by grinding clinker, fly ash, granulated blast furnace slag. I will discuss the composite cement in detail in a separate video. I'll just like to mention here that composite cement was introduced in India only about 5 years back. And of course, in USA and European countries, it has been used for a long time. Next one is rapid hardening Portland cement, that is RHPC. This cement has high C3S content and higher fineness, that is, finer grinding is done for this type of cement. The high strength at early age is due to finer grinding. The strength obtained by this cement in 3 days is same as obtained by OPC in 7 days. So that is the advantage. Then applications, it is used for prefabricated construction, emergency road repairs, in construction where form work is required to be removed early for reuse, and it is also used for cold weather. Next one is extra rapid hardening cement. It is obtained by intergrinding calcium chloride with rapid hardening cement. Addition of calcium chloride should not exceed 2% by way of rapid hardening cement. Concrete made by using this cement should be transported, placed, compacted, and finished within about 20 minutes. Strength is higher than 25% than that of rapid hardening cement at 1 or 2 days. Next one is quick setting cement. This cement is manufactured by adding a small percentage of aluminium sulfate and reducing gypsum content. Says it sets faster than OPC. Initial setting time is 5 minutes and final setting time is 30 minutes. That is why it is known as fixating cement. Applications, it is used for grinding of grouting operations and for underwater. Then we have low heat Portland cement, that is LHPC. It is produced by keeping low percentage of C3A and C3S and high percentage of C2S to keep heat generation low. It has lower early strength and it is slow in hardening and produces less heat. And it is applications used in basically mass concrete constructions like bridges, dams, etc. Next one is sulfate resisting Portland cement, that is SRPC. This cement contains C3A less than 5% and twice C3A plus CF4 is less than 25%. This cement is resistant to sulfate attack. This cement requires longer period of curing. It develops strength slowly, but ultimately its strength is as OPC. Applications, it is used for underground structure in sulfate salt rich environment, sewage treatment plant. Next is super sulfated cement, that is SSC. It is produced by grinding granulated blast furnace slag, that is 80 to 85%, CaSO4, calcium sulfate, 10 to 15%, and clinker, 5%. It is ground finer than OPC, and it considerably lower heat, it has got considerably lower heat of hydration. And it is high resistant to sulfate. Applications used in marine structure and mass concrete. Next one is hydrophobic Portland cement, HPC. This is produced by grinding clinker and water repellent film forming substance such as oleic acid, stearic acid, etc. An amount added is 0.1 to 0.5%. It is manufactured especially for high rainfall areas to improve the cement shelf life. It can be stored for longer periods in extreme wet climatic conditions. Next one is white Portland cement, that is WPC. It is made from raw materials containing very little iron oxide and manganese oxide. Furnace oil or gas are used in place of coal for firing in cement. Applications, it is meant for non-structural and decorative use. Used for flooring, general architectural purposes such as mosaic tiles, decorative concrete wall painting. Next one is masonry cement, that is MC. It is produced by grinding clinker with pozzolanic materials or inert materials and gypsum and air entraining. It has low compressive strength and hence used for plastering and brickwork. Next we have wild well cement, that is WC. This cement is specially formulated so that its slurry remains pumpable at high temperature and pressure. C3A content is kept low so that cement takes long time to set, but once it gets set, it develops strength more than. Applications used for cementing the steel casing to the walls of the wild wells. Next is high alumina cement, that is HEC. It is produced by firing a mixture of bauxite, limestone, and iron oxide. It is a basically refractory cement. It has got high early strength development. Application, it is used where concrete structures are subjected to high temperature, like workshop, refractory, foundry, etc. It is also used where the concrete is subjected to frost and acidic action. Then we have colored cement, which is produced by adding 5 to 10% mineral pigments with Portland cement during a time of grinding. Types of pigments are selected according to the desired color. Applications, this cement is mainly used for interior and exterior decorating. Then we have air entraining cement. It is manufactured by adding 0.025 to 0.1% of air entraining agents to the ordinary Portland cement clinker. This causes the entrainment of very fine air bubbles in a concrete. This increases the resistance of the concrete to freeze-thaw damage in cold climates. Air entraining agents are generally made up of food resins, calcium agents, vegetable coils, and animal fat. By introducing air entraining agent, cross-resisting characteristics of hardened concrete is increased. Workability, segregation, and bleeding property of concrete is improved by using this cement. Applications, especially it is used in areas where the temperature is very low. It also resists the sulfate attack. It is used where the de-icing chemical is used. Then next one is expansive cement. Expansive cement is a type of cement that shows no change in volume on time. This type of cement also does not shrink while hardening or after that, but expands slightly with time. It is obtained by mixing sulfo-aluminate clinker with Portland cement and stabilizer. Applications mainly used for grouting anchor bolts, machine foundations, and pre-stressed concrete ducts.
आशा करते हैं दोस्तों आज आपको अच्छी खासी जानकारी हासिल हुई होगी। अगर हमारा वीडियो आपको पसंद आया हो लाइक और शेयर जरूर कीजिएगा। अगर हमारे यूट्यूब चैनल पर नए हैं सब्सक्राइब करना ना भूलें, बेल आइकन को जरूर हिट कीजिएगा जिससे आपको लेटेस्ट अपडेट नोटिफिकेशन मिलता रहेगा, हमारा मोटिवेशन बढ़ता रहेगा। और दोस्त मैं एक चीज़ और आपको बताना चाह रहा हूँ कि आने वाले सीरीज़ में आपको सीमेंट से रिलेटेड जितनी भी जानकारी आनी है, केमिस्ट्री से रिलेटेड, वो सारी वन बाय वन आती रहेंगी। आप बने रहिए और इंतज़ार करते रहिए, बने रहिए, नोट उसका बनाइए और सीमेंट केमिस्ट्री की पूरी जानकारी आपको इस चैनल के द्वारा प्राप्त हो जाएगा। वीडियो देखने के लिए बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद।